In order for a Glidecam stabilizer to work effectively, the system must be configured so it is properly balanced. Incorrect balance will lead to unstable and ineffective operation. In this demonstration, a length of tube is shown being manipulated while held near its center of gravity. In comparison, the same length of tube displays a great deal of instability when being manipulated far above its center of gravity. Shown side by side for direct comparison, this demonstration reveals the clear difference between manipulating an object near or far from its center of gravity. Here, the handheld Glidecam 2000 Pro stabilizer is shown in motion with the system configured so it is properly balanced. In comparison, the Glidecam 2000 Pro displays a great deal of instability when balanced incorrectly. Shown side by side for direct comparison, this demonstration reveals the clear difference between a handheld stabilizer that is correctly balanced versus a handheld stabilizer that is incorrectly balanced. The stabilizer on the left is correctly balanced because it has just the right amount of bottom heaviness. The stabilizer on the right is incorrectly balanced because it is too bottom heavy. If the stabilizer is too top heavy, the system will simply turn upside down, so the heaviest part of the system moves towards the lowest position. When you pick up a Glidecam 2000 Pro that has correct horizontal balance, it will remain level. When you pick up a Glidecam 2000 Pro that has incorrect horizontal balance, it will either tip to the front, the back, the left, or to the right. To bring the system into correct horizontal balance, you will need to adjust either the position of the head plate in its front to back location, or the position of the mid plate in its left to right location. To fine-tune the horizontal balance of the system, adjust the position of the counterweight discs on the base platform. This method allows for very accurate and fine control over the system's horizontal balance. Your goal in making any of these adjustments is to reposition the system's center of gravity until the Glidecam remains level when lifted from a table. A Glidecam 2000 Pro that has correct vertical balance will remain level when it is set in motion. A Glidecam 2000 Pro that has incorrect vertical balance will not remain level when it is set in motion. To bring the system into correct vertical balance, you will need to either add or subtract counterweight discs from the base platform. To fine-tune the vertical balance of the system, simply adjust the position of the telescoping post either up or down. This method allows for very accurate and fine control over the system's vertical balance. You can test for correct vertical balance by counting how many seconds it takes for the central post to move from horizontal to vertical. If the system is vertically balanced correctly, this should take about 1.5 to 3 seconds to occur, depending on the size and weight of the camera you are using. Your goal in making any of these adjustments is to reposition the system's center of gravity until the Glidecam remains level when in motion.